I will never be the same again. I can never return, I've closed the door. I will walk the path, I'll run the race, and I will never be the same again. Fall like fire, soak like rain, flow like mighty waters again and again. Sweep away the darkness, burn away the chaff, and let a flame burn to glorify your name.
Good morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome on this very chilly weekend to St. Matthew's Church. It's very good to welcome you for our Sunday morning worship on Sunday, the 17th of January. And we are still in the season of Epiphany. All of the signs of Christmas and of Epiphany have disappeared now from behind us, but we are still in the season of Epiphany, which is all about it being revealed to us who Jesus really is. And we continue to think about that today as we think about the account in John's Gospel of the calling of some of the first disciples as they met with Jesus, as they discovered who he was and is, and were called to follow him. And we're going to be thinking about that, what that means for ourselves today. It's a team effort, as usual. Tim's going to be helping to lead our worship after our first song. The musicians, as through all this time, have been working together around the country to put our music together, and I really appreciate all they've done. Steve is behind the camera, helping to record. Manor has been working on the slides. It's a great team effort. So thank you to everyone for offering your gifts in the service of God and in the service of our church at this time. And also, we're going to have our This Time Tomorrow interview, and this week Vicky interviewed Dean. So as we begin, as we come into God's presence, let's offer ourselves afresh to him in this worship, and we're going to do that by saying together the words on the screen. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and also with you. God in Christ has revealed his glory. Come, let us worship. From the rising of the sun to its setting, the Lord's name is greatly to be praised. Give him praise, you servants of the Lord. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And we praise God as we sing now, Blessed Assurance.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine. Heirs of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my side. Angels descending, bring from above echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. this my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I am my Savior, and happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Praising my Savior.
Good morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome. We'll continue our service this morning with our confession and absolution. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. Let us confess our sins. God of all nations, revealed to us by the wise men, forgive us when we feel fear for the other. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Forgive us when we do not make the effort to journey to the end, but give up disheartened. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Forgive us when we do not lay our gifts down, but want to keep them to ourselves. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Forgive us for being people who choose to walk in darkness. Help us to turn to your revealing light, so we may recognize you as being here amongst us, today and always. Amen. We now hand over to Marcus, Rachel, and Ethan for our next song, I Will Never Be the Same Again.
I will never be the same again. I can never return. I've closed the door. I will walk the path. I'll run the race. And I will never be the same again. I will never be the same again. I can never return. I've closed the door. I will walk the path. I'll run the race. And I will never be the same again. For like fire, soak like rain, flow like mighty waters again. Again, sweep away the darkness, burn away the chaff, and let a flame burn to glorify your name. There are higher heights, there are deeper seas. Whatever you need to do, Lord, do it. Fills my life, and I will never be the same again. waters again and again. Sweep away the darkness, burn away the chaff, and let a flame burn to glorify your name. Oh, fall like fire, soak like rain, flow like mighty waters again and again. Oh, sweep away the darkness, burn away the chaff, and let a flame burn to glorify your name. I will never be the same again. I can never return, I've closed the door. I will walk the path, I'll run the race, and I will never be the same again. Oh, I will never be the same again.
Our collect for Epiphany. Eternal Lord, our beginning and our end, bring us with the whole creation to your glory, hidden through the past ages and made known in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. It's time for our This Time Tomorrow feature as Vicky interviews Dean Pravidi.
Good morning, Sir Matthew. Today is a wonderful day. I have to say that I feel privileged, you know, and Richard asking me to do the interview for Dean. I know so many of you know him, and you know him because he is part of our, he's member of our worship group, and he's singing for us, and I have to say, and a beautiful anointing man of God, and especially when he lead us in worship. I have to say that, because it's really good. So today, as we start again, this time tomorrow, and is the interview to try to know more members of our church, what they're doing, how they feel doing. And so I think it's good. It's a good thing. So Dean, welcome.
Hello, Vicky. How are you?
I'm good, man. Missing you in our recording in the afternoon sometime.
I know, all the time. I'm missing everyone all the time.
Are you working again? So I don't, you know, I understand you don't have so much time. Because that other thing, and he used to recording us in the evening service. So that was good to have him around sometime. So today, we have Dean Pravidi. I tried to do this with all the Italian that he has.
Pravidi, but close enough. It's good.
With us, we want to ask him, you know, how things is going with him. So the first question is, what will you be doing this time tomorrow?
This time tomorrow, I will be working from home since this lockdown 3.0 has started. I'm now working from home. By day, I'm a transport compliance supervisor, but by night, I am a part-time network marketer with Herbal Life Nutrition, Vicky.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, that tastes so good. That tastes so good, guys.
Can you say that people can follow you in YouTube and you see all the exercising that you do?
All the exercising, healthy living, healthy breakfast, so many healthy products. You'll find something you love for everyone.
That is good.
And their vision is to make the world a healthier and happier place. So I think that's a vision.
That's amazing. Well, I'm not going to talk about me, but later we talk about that. I am following you. Our second question is, what joys will you be looking forward to tomorrow when you're going to start your day?
Freedom, Vicky. Freedom. Freedom to go anywhere again. Freedom to see you, the church family, friends, my family, just without all these silly little restrictions. So yeah, that would be a joy. But also, what I'd really like to see from people is after this time, that everyone has bettered themselves in some way. We're more tolerant with each other. We care about each other more. We appreciate each other and the world more, you know, that we've changed from this some way. Not just that we've been stuck indoors for all this time, but during this time, we've all learned something that what we've taken from it and learned and grown.
That's amazing. That's good. And I think people want to know about the joys of your job, and both of the jobs that you have. What the joys you have in your job?
So my day-to-day job in transport, my joys from that is having a fantastic team of administrators and drivers around me that really want to achieve the best standards all the time and keep driving to do more and more and more, how we can make the roads safer in general, really. Because everything, every little thing we do adds to that safety on the road. So it's all worthwhile. And the part-time job, well, this great community is fantastic.
That's good.
We all inspire each other, motivate each other. This is how we keep going.
Well, the next question is, what challenges will you be facing in your job and both of them tomorrow?
Just staying sane in general. It was a challenge before lockdown. It's even more of a challenge now. No, but working from home has brought its own challenges, and I really got to grab that and look after my mental health and physical health. And the communication with the team on days and nights can suffer a bit, so I've got to put extra effort in working on the communication of the team.
Because
if things were hard before, you know, where we misunderstand each other, they're even harder now when you haven't got that face-to-face interaction. So that would be a challenge. But yeah, mental health is just at an all-time high, so looking after my mental health will be the biggest.
The biggest thing. Okay.
But as long as you're working it every day, it's fine.
That's fine. Absolutely. I think mental health now is something that we need to take care every day, you know, every day. And that's just good. How is going your music? Are you singing more and you with your composition? What are you doing?
A little bit less than the first lockdown, because the first lockdown I was on furlough, so I had time. I was helping doing the videos with St. Matthew's. I had plenty of time to work on the music and singing. So it's slightly gone less, if I'm honest, but I'm still involved with the music group and I'm still singing because I love to sing. And when I get the chance these days, it's even more powerful because it's
your passion. Yeah.
Yeah, it's back my passion and a little bit less time to work on it. So I love doing that. And I encourage anyone out there who can play the spoons or anything, get involved with the music group because it's a lot of fun.
That's good. So the last question is, in what way can we pray for you now? I'm going to pray for you. So let's have to know what thing do you think we can pray for you?
Okay. If you're asking me specifically, then pray for continued strength.
For you.
Each day, yeah. Just in general strength. And that I focus on him first, then myself, then others, in that order. And I don't mix the order up, you know?
Okay.
So, because when my cup is full, I can pour to others.
That's it. Absolutely.
This is it. And that just everyone in the community right now just is a little bit lenient, more lenient with each other and just care about each other a little bit more because, yeah, we're in strange times. But it'll be through. Everything passes. Everything's temporary.
Good.
Amen.
I like it. I like it, that prayer. So let's pray together now. And I'm going to pray for you. I have to say that I have been receiving so much blessing in the time that we have been working together. And, in you know, seeing you singing always is a blessing. So
when
let's
I was doing
pray.
Morning and evening prayers with you and Richard, that was a blessing because I had direct one-to-one with you and it was
that's good. Let's pray together. Lord, thank you for the time that you are giving to Dean now. It's a time for him to reflect, to open doors, to go to places that he never been before. And Lord, I pray for his continuous strength in you. Then you continue to be closer to him. Then he make himself more closer to you every day. In all the aspects of his life, then you blessing him with the power of your love. And you companion him, Lord, in every single new dream that he has. Lord, he asked to pray for he be focused on you. And it's so beautiful. And I pray, Lord, that he every day could see you first, see you present, see what you want for him, Lord, because you are the way. You are not one way. You are the only way. And be focused on you, Lord, is to go in that way. So I pray that he have it every day. He focus on you, Lord. And he focus on his mental health, physical health, and Lord, and he can grow in, and he can do it better for his body and his mind and his soul and his spirit. Lord, and so as he say, he could help other people. He could taking people with him in the journey, and he can help because he's strong. So I pray to make him stronger and stronger in you every day, Lord. Lord, and I pray as well for his concern about community, that us as a community get closer, closer to you in an amazing way, Lord. So I pray, Lord, we pray for our community. Thank you for the quality of people that is around us, Lord, for the people that is taking, you know, that journey with us, Lord. Lord, thank you for the future because you are in control. I know, Lord, that soon we're going to see each other and we're going to enjoy to be together. We fear or anything because you are with us and you are God and you love take the fear out. So I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, for the life of them. Then you give him peace, love, Lord, and companion. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Beautiful, Vicky.
It was so good to do this interview with you this time tomorrow. So see you soon. You want to say bye to the congregation?
Bye, everyone. See you soon. Don't worry. We'll get through it together. Don't forget.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Vicky.
Our gospel reading this morning comes from the book of John and is read by Jesse, followed by a talk from Richard.
The reading is taken from John chapter 1, verses 43 to the end. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ was revealed in flesh, proclaimed among the nations, and believed in throughout the world. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now, Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you come to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you'll see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." This is the word of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Have you ever had the experience of visiting somewhere amazing, somewhere life-changing even, and thought to yourself, I would love so-and-so to come and see this with me? If you are of a certain age, you will probably remember the old TV travel program, which was called Wish You Were Here. 5 years ago, I took my sabbatical and I went on a pilgrimage to Israel. And every day I saw and experienced amazing sights. On several evenings, I rang home or we had a FaceTime call and I'd tell Louise and the kids what I'd seen. But of course, it just wasn't the same as far as I was concerned as if they'd been there. And there were many occasions when I thought to myself, I wish you were here. I want you to see this for yourselves. And that was true no more so than on the day when we went to the Sea of Galilee. And I was standing on a hill on this beautiful day, looking out over the Sea of Galilee and thinking to myself, this scene is largely unchanged since Jesus' day. And think to myself, I wish Louise was here to see this because she would love it. Well, God willing, we'll get there one day and we'll see that together. Come and see. When we see something exciting, something that has a profound effect on us, it's natural for us to want to tell others and for them to experience it for themselves. And that's the pattern that we see in this part of John's gospel as Jesus gathers his first disciples. The phrase we keep hearing is, come and see. One person meets Jesus, their life is transformed, and the first thing they then do is tell someone else, come and see. Come and experience what I have just experienced. There's a chain of transmission, not the sort of horrible chain of transmission we're used to hearing about at the moment, but a beautiful chain of transmission of faith from one person to another. It starts with Andrew, who has heard John the Baptist speak about Jesus. Andrew responds by giving his life to Jesus and starts to follow him. And then he goes to tell his brother Simon and brings him to Jesus. So begins the discipleship of Simon Peter. And then there's Philip, and Philip, it seems, knows Andrew and Simon because they're all from Bethsaida by the lake. And Philip meets Jesus, he gives his life to Jesus, and he begins to follow. And then off he goes to find his friend, Nathanael. So we come to Nathanael. Nathanael is from Cana, which was a mile or so down the road from Nazareth. I remember on my pilgrimage being on the coach driving out of Nazareth, where we were staying, driving to the Sea of Galilee, driving through all these streets, thinking we were still in Nazareth. And the guide said, actually, we're now in Cana. So they're very close to each other. Sometimes you find friendly, or perhaps not always entirely friendly, rivalry between neighbouring places and people having strong views about where they're from and about the place next door. When I arrived in Usley, I quickly discovered that if you said someone was from Usley, whereas in fact they were from West Drayton or vice versa, you would very quickly be put right. Well, when Nathanael hears that this man who Philip thinks is the Messiah is from Nazareth, Nathanael is full of derision. Nazareth? Can anything good come from there? And you can see his point. Nazareth is just a tiny, insignificant place in the middle of nowhere. There are other much more significant places around, not least the new cosmopolitan city, Sepphoris, which is actually just over the hill. Why on earth would the Messiah come from Nazareth, of all places? So this persuading Nathanael to follow Jesus is not going well so far, is it? But the turning point is when Philip says, come and see. Philip doesn't try to argue with Nathanael's doubts and derision. He simply says, come and see. Come and see Jesus for yourself. Come and experience what I've experienced. And sure enough, it's when Nathanael meets Jesus that his doubts melt away. The first thing that happens is that as Nathanael approaches, Jesus calls out to Nathanael. Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit. You can hear the humor and imagine the glint in Jesus' eyes as he says that. Jesus is hinting there at the story of Jacob, the ancient Israelite who, of course, was known for his deceit. More about Jacob a bit later. But something in what Jesus has said makes Nathanael realize that Jesus knows who he is, even though the implication is that they've never met. Nathanael is intrigued now. Where did you come to know me? He says. And Jesus replies, well, I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you. Now, we don't know why Nathanael was under the fig tree, although apparently sometimes people would sit under fig trees to listen to the rabbi, so maybe that was the reason. And we also don't know what it was that Jesus noticed in Nathanael. Doesn't matter. But the fact that Jesus has noticed Nathanael and that Jesus already knows him changes everything for Nathanael. His skepticism melts away. And in fact, he goes from one extreme to the other. So from saying one minute, this Jesus, if he's from Nazareth, well, he can't possibly be the Messiah, to the next minute, an extraordinary confession of faith and a promise to follow. Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel. In this season of Epiphany, this is Nathanael's epiphany. This is his light bulb moment when he realizes who Jesus really is. But Jesus goes on to say to him, in effect, well, you have seen, but there's so much more to see. Jesus says, very truly, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. What's that all about? Well, this is another reference to Jacob, this time to Jacob's experience in Genesis chapter 28. When at a particularly low point in Jacob's life, when he's made disastrous mistakes and he's running away, he encounters God and he dreams of a stairway or a ladder with angels going up and down between heaven and earth. It's a vision of heaven and earth brought close together. So now Jesus is saying to Nathanael, follow me, and you will now see a new way in which God will be present with his people. You will experience what it means that the Word has become flesh, in the phrase that John uses at the beginning of his gospel. Jesus is saying to Nathanael, follow me, and you will see what it's like when heaven and earth come together. And that, of course, is then played out as Nathanael does follow Jesus and he witnesses Jesus' ministry over the next 3 years and he sees Jesus bring God's kingdom into our world. Come and see. That's the invitation that Jesus offers to all of us. Come and see Jesus who already knows you. He knows whoever you are, and whatever you've done, and he loves you and he welcomes you. Come and see Jesus, who will help you to see reality like you've never seen it before. Come and see Jesus, who will reveal God to you. Come and see Jesus, who will bring the reality of heaven to earth. Come and see Jesus, who invites you to follow him, to be with him forever, and to be part of building God's kingdom in the here and now, here on earth. And when you've come and when you sing for yourself, invite others to do the same. Be part of that same beautiful chain of transmission we see in John's Gospel and has gone on through Christian history. Don't keep the amazing, life-changing discovery of who Jesus is to yourself. Pass it on. You don't need all the answers to all the questions. Just do as Andrew did for Simon and Philip did for Nathaniel. Say to someone you know who doesn't know Jesus, come and see. And then leave the rest to Jesus. You know, this year, so many people are searching for meaning and truth and hope in the midst of all that the world is experiencing. We believe that lies in Jesus. So I wonder who comes to mind. Who do you know to whom you could say this year, come and see? And help them to their light bulb moment as they meet Jesus and they follow him. Amen.
Jesus, when you speak to me, I hope I'm listening to you. Let this heart of mine receive what is full of grace and truth. Whisper, whisper, whisper in my ear. Tell me words I thought I'd never hear. Show me, show me, show me what you see. Illuminate what's right in front of me. Sometimes I'm scared to take it in. Is that you right in front of me? Are you the stranger or the friend? Whisper, whisper, whisper in my ear. Oh, tell me words I thought I'd never hear. And show me, show me, show me what you see. Yeah. Illuminate what's right in front of me. Oh, would you whisper in my ear? Let it find room in my heart, like a garden that your words begin to grow. When my faith is prone to fear, remind me of your love. Remind me that you'll never let me go. Remind me of your love. Remind me of your love. Remind me of your love. Oh, remind me of your love.
Thank you to Richard for your talk, and thank you to Dean for your song. We continue this morning with the affirmation of faith. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We now go to our intercessions led by Di.
We bring to you, our loving God and Father, all that we are today. We come with memories of the last week and our hopes and fears for the week to come. In the stillness, quieten our hearts and minds, and take from us the strain and stress that weigh us down. Give us instead, we pray, a sense of compassionate presence and the beauty of your peace. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. Grant us, Lord, to look with your eyes of compassion at the long struggle of mankind, the wars, the hungry millions, and the countless refugees. the victims of natural disasters, the cruel and needless deaths, the heartbreak and hopelessness of so many lives. By our prayers and through our lives, we pray that all nations shall be at peace and all people shall live free from fear and free from want. And all your children will live in the security of your will and assurance of your love. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. Lord, as this pandemic continues, we bring before you those who are suffering physical pain of the body, emotional distress of the mind, and emptiness of spirit. You know the deepest needs of each one of us. And we ask that you, in your love and mercy, you will minister to those needs. We pray for our food bank, our leaders, locally, nationally, and internationally, our emergency service, our local hospital, and all who volunteer their services during this pandemic. We remember in prayer those affected by COVID, Karen and JP, Adela, Nalini, Christina, Zamara, and we also remember in prayer Rena, who sadly lost her battle with COVID on Friday. We pray for Adam and Susie, Bruce and Mary and Mark. Comfort them in this time, please, Lord. We also pray for Jason, Antonia, and Frankie, who are gravely ill. And at this time, you may like to name the person in silently that you have in your heart. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We pray for our homes that they may be filled with your presence. Make them homes of peace and kindliness, of holiness and hospitality, of grace and goodness, that you may be known to be among us. Lord, help us to be more outward looking, to care for our neighbors, and be more aware of the needs of people around us. Lord of glory, hear our prayer. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
So we continue in this time of prayer by saying together the Lord's Prayer, and please, as usual, join in with our all age actions. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So here's a few bits of news and notices, things coming up this week. So as most of you know, the church building is currently closed for worship, but we're still very much at work. We're online for our services, for prayer, and for lots of our different groups. And the building does remain open for food bank, using West Drayton Food Bank, for the door advice service, and for AA. So Later on today at 12:30, we have our monthly quiz. It's just a simple, fun quiz for 45 minutes and just a chance to have a bit of fun together. So please do join with that, even if you haven't joined in previous months. And the details of how to join that will have been on the MailChimp email, which will have come round. So have a look at that. You can either join by video or you can join by phone, and it's just a local phone call. So hopefully see you at 12:30 today. And then we have all our usual services, morning and evening prayer, and other groups during the week. Can I particularly mention the Fellowship Cafe, which is tomorrow between 10 and 11 on Zoom. That's particularly for older church and community members. Chance just to catch up over a cup of coffee or a cup of tea and see how people are. So again, if you haven't done that before, come along. Particularly if you're feeling a bit lonely at the moment, come along and we'll just catch up with each other from 10 to 11 tomorrow morning. Can I just remind you of a couple of things I said last week about the state of the pandemic locally? First of all, a reminder that there is a chance for asymptomatic testing. So even if you're someone who has no symptoms, you can go and get a test, go onto the Hillingdon Council website, and you can book in advance, and then you can go and get tested at the Beck Theatre. There's also a site, as it happens, in Northwood. And also, if you're a key worker, you can get tested at the Civic Centre. I've been a couple of times now. It's very efficient. It's very quick. Please do it. It really helps the community. Secondly, a reminder, as last week, that when you are called for a vaccine, please can I encourage you to go and get vaccinated. I am going to get vaccinated as soon as I'm called. There are people spreading myths around in the country, among particular communities, about the vaccine and trying to put people off having the vaccine. That is wrong, in my view. And please do your duty, civic duty, I think it is, to go and get vaccinated. So can I encourage you to do that? And lastly, as I mentioned last week, please can I encourage you to continue, if you're able to give regularly to the work of St. Matthew's Church. And particularly if you're someone who usually comes to church and gives money in the plate, which we're obviously not able to do at the moment, can we encourage you to give to the work of the church? And the easiest way to do it is to go onto our website, onto the giving page, and you can either give a one-off donation or you can set up more regular giving on there. And the details of how to do that will be on a slide again at the end of our service today. So let's move on to birthdays. Got two birthdays to mention this week. Tomorrow it is Carlos's birthday. I hope Carlos will get this. He's actually in Colombia at the moment, hoping to come home later this week. He's with his parents at the moment. So a very happy birthday to Carlos. And this is quite an international birthday event this week because Carlos is in Colombia and the other person's birthday we're celebrating is Rachel. It's her birthday on Tuesday and she's in Wales. So happy birthday to Rachel. And we're going to sing happy birthday to them now. And that's going to be led by Hayley this week on the recorder. And then after that, we're going to sing our final song, a great hymn about following Jesus. We have a gospel to proclaim.
Of his birth at Bethlehem. sinner's table door, until the Word made flesh a light for all.
Hailed on his death at Calvary, hated by those he came to save, in lonely suffering on the cross for all. He loved his life he gave.
To the first glorious Easter Day, empty the tomb, for he was free. He broke the bar of death that held at me.
So we've been thinking today about that continuing Epiphany theme of it being revealed to us who Jesus is, coming and seeing who Jesus is, seeing his glory, and then following and then passing that on to others. Let's go with that charge to come and see Jesus and pass the glory of him on to others to discover this year. And that's reflected now in our closing blessing. Christ our Lord, to whom kings bow down in worship and offer gifts, reveal to you his glory and pour upon you the riches of his grace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and upon all those you love, today and always. Amen.
So go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. I'd like to thank you all for watching this morning. I'd like to thank everyone who took part in this morning's service. I'd like to wish you all a safe and peaceful week and a very happy new year. Goodbye.